Alright, so we've got the basics down of modeling a part in SolidWorks. Now it's time to turn our attention to building drawings. Building a drawing from a model is very straightforward in SolidWorks. But before we dive into that, I actually want to take some time to set up our drawing sheet format. So all drawings typically have a border around them with information about who drew it, what units are used, what the scale is, and so on. And it makes a lot of sense to build your own sheet format and at the same time build your own document properties. So in this video we're going to talk about how you do that. To get started, we'll click on New and we'll say we're going to start a new drawing. Alright, and this is the format that comes up, or the dialog that opens. We're going to go ahead and start with an A-size drawing, and you can see SolidWorks comes with some built-in title blocks. And you can choose to display those or not based on this little checkbox right here where it says Display Sheet Format. I'm going to go with not displaying it right now and click on OK. And by default, SolidWorks says, hey, I bet you want to import some model views. We're not going to do that right off the bat, so I'm going to just click the Xbox in the Property Manager, and we're just looking at our sheet drawing here. Now, to edit the sheet format, I can come over here on the sheet in the Property Manager and right-click and go Edit Sheet Format. All right. Now I can use my basic normal sketch tools to drag a border out and then to add a title block in the bottom right corner. Okay, a couple things I want to do here though. First, let's go ahead and get the border set with just the right dimensions. You'll notice if I select the dot in the corner, I can then select and put in the 3/8 border there, and then if I click on the fix relation, that will fix that point. And do the same thing up here. I want this to be 10.625 and 8.125 in order to make that a 3/8 border at the top. Fix that button or the point there, and you can see my border is now turned black. I also probably want my border to be a thicker line weight so that it's really clear that it's not part of the model geometry. And in order to do that, I click on the line thickness here. If this toolbar isn't viewable, you get it by right-clicking in the Command Manager and then coming down to Line Format. So I unclicked it so it's not viewable here. Right-click again and add the Line Format toolbar. And then with my line selected, if I click here on the line thickness, I can go ahead and thicken that up a bit. And now I have a nice dark border around the edges. I'm going to zoom in down to my title block here, and I'm going to draw some lines real quickly. I probably want to put a line. I'm going to divide it here. Okay, and now I'm going to dimension these guys. You can really set this up however you like, make it look how you want. And the basic thing you need to make sure that you do is that you have enough space in there to put in all the information you want. Okay, so it's fully defined, looks good, but I don't want dimensions on my title block to always be visible. So I can hide them, and I can do that by right-clicking. I can click on each individual one and say hide, right? So that's an easy thing to do. Or alternatively, if I want to hide all of them, I come up here to View and Hide Show Annotations, and I can go around and it will let me click all of them at once and then hit enter and they all disappear. Okay, so this is fully defined geometry, but the dimensions are hidden, and that's what we want because we don't want dimensions on our title block all the time. Now it's time to add some information in there. I recommend that you make two different sheet formats, one for the English system and one for the metric, so an inch and a millimeter typically. And you can set your dimensions then in a note so people know what size, what type of dimensions you're using. So if you come to the annotation toolbar in the Command Manager, click on Note, and you can say dimensions in inches and degrees. Okay, and this is just normal like Word. You can format that guy, set its size. Okay, and then once you're done, drag it into the whatever box you want it in. So it looks like it's a little bit too big there, so I'm going to actually go ahead and size it down to font 10 and it fits pretty nicely. I'll move it over a little bit, get it centered. Okay. Let's see, what else are we going to want? We might want a company logo. In my case, I'm going to go ahead and choose Insert and Picture, and I have this Mount Hood logo saved, and I can choose, it's put it over here. A couple options when you have logos you can enable the scale to. I'm going to unclick that. I'm going to scale this down and drag it and place it over here in this box. I need to scale it a little bit smaller. And there my logo fits right in there. Okay, so you could change this to a company logo or whatever makes sense to you. It's also a good idea. I'll hit check. There we go. Looks nice. I'm going to add a note that says who drew this, right? So this isn't something that's going to change because this is my sheet format. So I'm going to go ahead and say drawn by Andrew. Okay. And now I can scale this as well, change its font size. Maybe I'll make that 10. And this doesn't need to change, right? Because this is your own custom sheet format, so you can keep that the same. Now, there are things that you probably want to put on here that might change and that you want to have by default. So for instance, I could put scale. Okay, so we want to know what scale is the drawing at. And if I grab my note here, I'm going to change the scale of that, or the size of that actually, down to size 10. And I'm going to add another note right next to it, but this note, I'm going to come over to the property manager, and you see we have some commands here. And one of the commands is to link it to a property. And I can link it to a property in this document or another document. You see there's a big giant list of properties. And the one that I'm going to use is the sheet scale. And it just pulls up this box. Now this is linked to the scale of the sheet. So as the sheet scale changes, so would this value. Okay. And I'm going to change that to be font 10 as well. And escape. If you're having trouble getting it snapping to things, if you hold down the Alt key and move it, it will move just exactly as you like. Notice that that stays blue. It's tied to the sheet scale here. I'll go ahead and add the date as well. Okay, a couple more things that I probably need to add here. I'm going to add, I forgot to add a title of my drawing, so I'll just go ahead and add another line here. Comes across. All right. And this guy, here I'll add another note and just have it say title. Okay, and you have a couple choices here. I like to by default just link this to the title of the part you're using, so SOLIDWORKS file name right there. Okay, and this then will update as you save your file. So I haven't saved this yet, so it's just going to be draw 2 in this case, and that's just fine. I'll just leave it that way. The last note that I want to add then is some default tolerancing information. Okay, so rather than having to call out your tolerances everywhere, it's nice to just put a default tolerances. Okay, this will save you some time and make sure that your drawings are done correctly. You can just add this for each of your dimensions here. So what this is saying is that if there's just one decimal point, it's plus or minus 0.1 units. If there's two decimal places, it's plus or minus 0.01 units. Okay, and you want to adjust these based on your drawing needs, but it's nice to just put them in as a default, and you can edit them on a per sheet basis if you need to. And here I can say this is plus or minus 0.001. And then for the angles, I can say that's just generically plus or minus, plus or minus 1. All right. Again, I'll select all of that and change it to 10. And let's space it out so that it looks a little bit nicer. All right. So a couple of things that I want to change on this. I said that this is dimensions in inches and degrees. If I want to change some of those properties, I can always, I guess I'll exit my sheet format, and then right click, and I can change properties here. I always want to use third angle projection, so I like that. I'm going to go ahead and cancel out of this, and then come up to my options up here, where I can change systems and documents properties. I can click on drawings, tons of different options here, but I'm going to actually go over to document properties and look at drafting standards. I want to use ANSI, which is the American National Standards Institute, and then I can look at the dimensions, or excuse me, annotations, different features I can change, as well as dimensions. I'll look at detailing here. I want to go ahead and add center lines by default in my drawing, so I click that over here. Tons of different options. In units, this is where I change the precision of the units that are displayed. Not necessarily the precisions of actually what it is, but what's displayed. And I'm going to set this to a default of 2. Actually, in mechanical drawing, if I'm doing inch drawings, that will be a length. I'm going to keep that at 0.123. And I'm going to be using the inch pound second as my default. All right. You can change line font, styles, all sorts of different things can be changed in your document properties here. And if you save them with your sheet format, they will be saved for all future drawings. So I'm going to go ahead and click Save. And now I'm going to go and do a File, Save Sheet Format, and I'm going to call this Andy's Inch A Sheet. Okay. Now when I come up to New and go for a new drawing, if I scroll down, my sheet format Andy's A doesn't show, and that's because I have clicked Only Show Standard Formats. If I uncheck that box and scroll to the bottom, there's Andy's A sheet, and I can go ahead and click on Display and say OK, and look at that. I have a new drawing with my format already in here, shows the date, the scale, and the drawing name. All right. So now if I saved this drawing, I'm going to go ahead and do a Save As, and I'll save it as Andy. Notice that the title updates to Andy there. All right. Have fun. Make your own sheet format and use it well. If you want to make a second sheet format, I'd highly recommend that. You can go ahead and change the properties on this guy. If we come down or go back to our options, we could change the document properties, go to units, and make one that's for millimeters. I'll leave that as an exercise for you to do, but a good idea to have both a metric and an inch format. Thanks so much!